Hello and welcome. Yes, let's get. Hello and welcome to RD Parker versus College Bolivar. Introducing coaches Mackenzie, Chris, Christine, Bonnie, and Bonnie. And for the starting lineup, Jolie Alut.
Number 13.
Number 11, Bridget Caddy. Number 12, Maisie Dilbert. Number 2, Jersey Nabes. And number 4, Charity Trout.
Introducing College Bolivar's coaches, Jade, Chantal, Pat, and Scott. For the starting lineup, number 15, Vienna Bussini. Number 20, Phoebe Mosky. Number 7, Mindy Murdoch. Number 1, Grace Neherniak. Number 11, Serena Patterson. And our minor officials, Acacia, Avery, and Amelia. And our officials, Scott and Eric. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh! Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
Beliveau's side. Congratulations to number 11, Serena Patterson. And for the other team, congratulations to number 12, Maisie Ginsburg. Thank you.
Okay, we're here with
some of the Bellevue Barracudas. Girls, can you introduce yourselves really quickly?
I'm Serena Patterson.
And I'm Grayson Herniak.
Okay, well, thank you for taking the time to chat with me today. Just a few questions before I let you guys go celebrate that nice win that you guys had there. So first of all, looking through the results that I see on MHSAA, it seems like you guys have had a very strong season, but you've never had the chance to play against RD Parker. How would you say that makes it a challenge for you to prepare for a game like this, where you had to play against a team you've never played before?
I'd say it's pretty difficult because we've never seen how they play. We don't know what defense they play and like who their players are, if they're tall and strong or if they're like short and fast. But I think our coach did a really good job at preparing us for this. And I think we all just kind of figured it out as a team on how to play against this team because they are really great. And as I said before, like tall and strong or short and fast, and they were tall and strong and fast. So it was hard to defend them. And yeah.
I'm going to ask a follow-up question to that.
Okay.
So it seemed like in the first quarter, second quarter, even the start of the third, you guys were keeping about a 10-point lead, and it was staying pretty even the whole game. Now, if we just think about that for a second, is there a message that your coach gave you guys at halftime as to how to advance? Because you ended up winning by almost 30 points.
Well, he gave us a lot of encouraging words that I'm kind of blanking right now on what he said. But yeah, he just told us to like stay positive and that we're a good team and we should just like keep playing as hard as we can. And we were getting a little bit tired, so he told us to just try and like keep playing our hardest, and that's what we tried to do.
That's great. Grace, I'll ask you a question now. So women's basketball in the last few years has really become much more in the spotlight. People like Brianna Stewart or Caitlin Clark, they've really helped raise the bar and just bring realization about how great of a game it is. How would you say those types of players have impacted the game at the grassroots level?
I feel like it starts directly, like, rootly from the crowd. Like, if you looked at our provincials last year, it would maybe be some parents that could make it out. And this year, it's like a whole different experience, and that kind of brings the game more fun. People are cheering. They want certain players on the court. They want you to do certain things. So it just, that is where the root starts. That brings the energy up, and then now we have more better streaming services for it, and it just changed the game completely because it's more competitive in a way, honestly, because people are rooting for people because they know who they are.
Yeah. Did you happen to see the game this morning with the host school playing?
Yes.
That was electric. Like, speaking about the crowd, it was crazy in here. Mm-hmm. So I agree 100%. The amount of people that are buying in and really getting excited about this game, it's phenomenal.
Yeah.
Next question, I'll pass it back over there. The provincial tournament here at Leo has been incredible. They were really well planned, and the execution of it has been great. Is there a certain memory that you're going to try and take home with you from the tournament itself?
I will definitely remember the music that they played before all the games. At first, I was like, oh, what is this music? You know, we usually play our own music. But then after, I was getting really into it, and it was really cool that they're all like Francophone Fier. And and also, the food was awesome at the banquet, and it was fun playing Bump, even though I may or may not have gotten up first. But it was still like really fun. I'll remember it forever.
Amazing. I love that. Are you guys grade 12 or grade 11?
I'm 11.
I'm 12.
Yeah.
So this is a big year. Tomorrow you'll be playing in the Constellation Final. Do you have any thoughts about how important the result is going to be versus just enjoying the experience?
I genuinely feel like basketball is about the experience. If I'm having a really, really bad game, I'm not playing well with my team and stuff, but we still win, is that really a win?
Yeah.
It's about the experience. Is everyone touching the ball? Or not even that, is everyone playing the best to their abilities? Maybe touching the ball isn't the best of their abilities, and they still win. Maybe they don't get any points and they win. So I think it's definitely all about the experience and the way you play with your team, as long as you're like having fun, communicating. Like, you set goals for your team, and if you achieve those goals and you still lose, it's still a win.
Absolutely. I love that. I love it. I love it. I love it. Last question before I let you guys go. So I want to give you an opportunity to recognize somebody who's been impactful in your life. So is there anybody that you want to say hello to, thank you to, anything? I'll leave it to you.
There's like a million people that I could say thank you to, like all of my coaches. I've had like a million coaches, rec and club, like Randy Cassano and like Coach Kornberger, like Brian Kornberger, and obviously my parents, because they've driven me to every practice. And like, it's not just like they'll either have to stay there or they'll have to go like all the way home and then come back and take me all the way back. And they give me so many, like I've said before, like encouraging words that help me out so much. And even like they watch all my games. And obviously our coach Scott Waugh, and he's helped us so much. And my dad has also coached, and he helps me a lot. And just like so many people, my teammates, they like help me so much. Just like, oh my gosh, like I, most of like all the good things that have ever happened with me in basketball are because of other people. So yeah, what about you?
Yeah, the people that most impacted like me for basketball is my parents, the commitment, and my grandpa, my Guido. But I would say the biggest shout out would be to Coach Souk with Attack Academy. He brought me in when I never played before, joined me as club, brought me to a tournament, and he built my game from just me playing soccer. So I knew nothing about basketball. I would just, you know, try and slide tackle people, and he's like, okay, pause. No. And he really just built my game and brought me to where I am now.
Okay, I gotta say one thing. You mentioned the soccer playing.
Yeah.
So I noticed when you play the game of basketball, you go down an awful lot. Is that a bit of a soccer dive kind of thing, or are you genuinely getting pushed down?
Well, I sprained my ankle.
Yes, I saw
that. So instead of landing on it, I decided to just land on my body, because I'm not trying to hurt it anymore.
Yeah.
So it was more like, and also I like to like, you know, get the calls.
Oh. All right. Well, after that, let's call it a day. I appreciate your guys' time. Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you.
And I wish you all the best.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.